times you get. That could be enough. Eat a good bowl of soup. Hell, out here digging graves again. You know who's gonna dig my grave when I die? Nobody. Because I'm the only grave digger out here.
What a day in paradise.
Scrooge never painted out old Marley's name. There it stood, years afterwards, above the warehouse door. Scrooge and Marley. The firm was known as Scrooge and Marley. Sometimes people new to the firm called Scrooge Scrooge, other times Marley, but he answered to both names. It was all the same to him. Oh, but he was a tight-fisted, covetous old sinner Scrooge, self-contained and solitary as an oyster. The cold within him froze his old features. He kept his low temperatures always about with him. Cold was his surest companion and preference. Cold was cheap.
Sir, the fire's out. Would it be... Do you think I could... Would it be all right?
Spit it out, Cratchit! If you want more coal, you are going to have to learn to form the request with your lips.
Sir, may I have another lump of coal?
No. You'll rob me blind, Cratchit. Don't think I'm not watching you. Good workers persevere while keeping their employers' overhead low.
Yes, sir.
Merry Christmas, Uncle. God save you.
Humbug.
Oh, Christmas a humbug, Uncle. You don't mean that, I'm sure.
I do. What reason have you to be merry? What right have you to be merry? You're poor enough.
Oh, come then. What reason have you to be dismal? What right have you to be morose? Are you rich enough? Don't be cross, Uncle.
Well, what else can I be when I live in such a world of fools as this? Merry Christmas? Out upon a Merry Christmas! What's the Christmas time but a time for paying bills with money you haven't got? Time for finding yourself a year older, not an hour richer? If I could work my will, every idiot who went about with a Merry Christmas on his lips should be boiled in his own pudding and buried with a stake of holly through his heart, he should.
Uncle!
Nephew, keep Christmas in your fashion, and let me keep it in mine.
Keep it? But you don't keep it.
Well, then let me leave it alone, then. Much good may it do you. Much good has it ever done you.
There are many things from which I might have derived good, by which I have not profited, I dare say. Christmas among the rest. But I am sure I've always thought of Christmas time, when it has come round, as not only a holy time, but a good time. A kind, forgiving, charitable, pleasant time. Well, it's the only time I know of, in a long calendar year, where men and women seem to open up their shattered hearts freely and to think of those below them as if they really were kind of passengers to the grave. Not another race of creatures bound on separate journeys. Therefore, Uncle, though it has never put a scrap of gold or silver in my pocket, I believe that it has done me good and will do me good, and I say, God bless it!
One more sound out of you, sir, and you shall keep your Christmas by losing your position. You're quite a powerful speaker, nephew. I wonder you don't go into Parliament.
Don't be angry, Uncle. Come, dine with us tomorrow.
I will see you in hell first.
But why? Why?
Why ever did you get married?
Because I fell in love.
Good day, sir.
Nay, Uncle, but you never came to see me before that happened. Why give it as an excuse for not coming now,
Good afternoon.
I want nothing from you, I ask nothing of you. Why cannot we be friends?
Good afternoon.
I am sorry with all my heart to find you so resolute. We have never had any quarrel to which I have been a party. But I have made the trial in homage to Christmas, and I'll keep my Christmas humor to the last. So, a Merry Christmas, Uncle!
Good afternoon!
And Happy New Year!
Well, good afternoon, sir!
Merry Christmas, Mr. Cratchit.
And Merry Christmas, too.
Now there's another fellow, my clerk, with 15 shillings a week and a wife and children talking about a Merry Christmas. I shall retire to Bedlam.
Oh, a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Scrooge and Mark.
Scrooge and Marley's, I believe. Have we the pleasure of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Mr. Marley died 7 years ago, this very night.
Oh, so sorry.
We have no doubt his liberality is well represented by his surviving partner.
At this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, it is more than usually desirable to make some slight provision for the poor and destitute. who suffer greatly at the present time.
Many thousands are in want of common necessaries. Hundreds of thousands are in want of common comforts, sir.
Are there no prisons?
Plenty of prisons.
And the union workhouses, are they still in operation?
They are, still.
The treadmill, the poor law, still in full vigor then?
Both very busy, sir.
I was afraid from what you had said that something had occurred to stop them. I'm very glad to hear it.
But they scarcely furnish Christian cheer of mind or body to the multitude.
A few of us are endeavoring to raise a fund to buy the poor some meat and drink and means of warmth.
We choose this time because it is a time of all others when want is keenly felt and abundance rejoices. What shall we put you down for?
Nothing.
You wish to remain anonymous?
I wish to be left alone! Since you ask me what I wish, that is my answer. I do not make merry myself at Christmas, and I cannot afford to make idle people merry. I pay to support the institutions that I have mentioned, and they cost enough. Those who are badly off must go there.
But many can't go there, sir.
And many would rather die.
Well, if they would rather die, they had better do it and decrease the surplus population. It is enough to know one's own business and not to interfere with other people's.
But, sir,
mine occupies me constantly. Good day to you.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Cat. Look over there.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you display. For Jesus Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Well done. Here you are.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, yes, I can't
believe it's such a young lady. God rest ye merry gentlemen, and not thank you.
You'll be wanting the entire day tomorrow, I suppose.
It's quite convenient, sir.
It's not convenient. And it's not fair. But if I were to stop you half a crown for it, you'd think yourself ill-used, I'll be bound. And yet you don't think me ill-used, have to pay a day's wages for no work.
Oh, I'm very sorry, sir. It's only once a year,
it's
sir.
It's a poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December. But I suppose you must have the entire day. Be here all the earlier the next morning.
Yes, sir. I will, sir. Thank you, sir.
Entire day for Christmas. Nonsense. Never missed a day of work in my life. Missed my own mother's funeral to be at work. Entire day. Highway robbery is what it is. Lower class nonsense. Entire day for Christmas, I ask you. Humbug, I say. Humbug. Housekeeper putting up this holiday nonsense. Not in my house. I know you're in here. Hallucination. Getting too old for this sort of thing, but a good night's rest, I believe, is what it's called for. For a moment, I thought I saw the face of Jacob Marley, but he's dead 7 Christmases ago. Buried him deep. Fool of a housekeeper has put far too much starch in my nightcap again. First the wreath, now the nightcap. She shan't be my housekeeper a night longer. But at least she's left me a tray of sandwiches. Woman can be counted upon to do one thing right, at least. Christmas nonsense. Why couldn't Christmas come every decade, or better, once a century, or better, not have come at all? Humbug, I say. humbug. Hello? Who's there?
Jacob Marley,
Tell me more, but speak comfort to me, Jacob.
I have none to give. It comes from other regions, Ebenezer Scrooge, and is conveyed by other ministers to other kinds of men. Nor can I tell you what I would. A very little more is all appointed to me. I cannot rest. I cannot stay. I cannot linger anywhere. I never walk beyond our counting house. Mark me! In life, my spirit never roved beyond the narrow limit of our money-changing home. Therefore, weary journeys are required of me, and lie before me now.
Well, you must have been very slow about it, Jacob.
Slow?
7 years dead, and traveling the whole time.
The whole time. No rest, no peace, incessant torture and remorse.
You travel fast?
On the wings of the wind.
Well, one would have thought you could have got over a great quantity of ground in 7 years.
Oh, captive, bound in double iron, not to know that no space of regret can make amends for one's life opportunity misused. Yet such was I. Oh, such was I.
But you were always a good man of business, Jacob.
Business? Mankind was my business. The common welfare was my business. Charity, mercy, forbearance, and benevolence were all my business. The dealings of my trade were but a drop of water in the comprehensive ocean of my business. The time of year I suffer most. Why did I walk through crowds of fellow beings with my eyes turned down? Never raise them to that blessed star which led the wise men to a poor abode. Were there no poor homes to which its light might have conducted me? Hear me. My time is nearly gone.
I will, but don't be hard upon me, Jacob, pray.
How it is that I may appear before you in the shape that you can see, I may not tell. I have sat invisible beside you many and many a day. That is no light part of my penance. I'm here tonight to warn you that you have yet a chance and hope of escaping my fate. A chance on hope of my procuring, Ebenezer.
Oh, you always were a good friend to me, Jacob, thank you.
You will be haunted by three spirits.
Is that the chance and hope you spoke of, Jacob?
It is.
Well, in that case, I think I'd rather not.
Without their visits, you cannot hope to shun the path I tread. Expect the first tomorrow, when the bell tolls one.
Couldn't I take them all at once and have it over, Jacob?
Expect the second on the next night at the same hour. The third on the next night when the last stroke of 12 has ceased to vibrate. Look to see me no more, and look that, for your own sake, you might remember what has passed between us. No!
Quarter past. to it. My word. I was brought up in this place.
I'll eat so much turkey they'll have to roll me away. I'll roll you away right now.
It's the pudding they'll have to pull me away from.
Chestnuts.
Rum cakes.
Raspberry tarts.
Raspberry tarts.
Robin! Will! Dash! It's me! It's Ebenezer!
They can't see you or hear you.
One, two, three!
To the red!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
The school is not quite deserted. A solitary child, neglected by his friends, is left there still.
I know it.
Do you recognize the lad?
I used to read stories. I used to pretend.
You were left all alone. Those characters in your books become all too real.
Poor boy. I wish I... It's too late. It's too late now.
What is the matter?
There were a boy and a girl singing a Christmas carol outside my door last night. I should like to have given them something. That's all.
Let us see another Christmas.
Well, Master Scrooge.
Yes, ma'am?
It appears you'll be leaving us today.
It appears so, ma'am.
Perhaps you might amount to something after all.
Thank you, ma'am.
But I doubt it.
Merry Christmas! A kick, a skip, skippity, skip! I'm done!
My dear Mrs. Fezziwig.
Oh, my dear old Fezziwig.
Merry Christmas, my love.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, your daughters are here.
Hello, dear girls.
Hello, Father.
Oh, the musicians are here! Oh, capital! Let them rule, let them rule! For we must dance! Thank you.
small matter.
What's that?
Just a trifle.
What is?
A small matter to make these silly folk so full of gratitude.
Small?
Ah, oh, what a time!
I don't think I will sleep. I'm all full up of cheer. God bless old Fezziwig.
Ah, he is kindness personified.
To the Fezziwigs.
The Fezziwigs!
May their generosity be long remembered.
And an example for all. Here, here!
I saw the way you danced with Bill's evening. It was lovely. Good work.
Why? Wouldn't you say a small matter?
What is?
Fezziwig has spent but a few pounds on his party. Is that so much he deserves all this praise?
Oh, no, it isn't on that spirit. It's not that. It's... Well, he has the power to render us happy or unhappy, to make our service light or burdensome, a pleasure or a toil. But the joy he brings is quite as much as if it had cost a fortune.
What is the matter?
Nothing particular.
Something, I think.
I should like to have a word or two with my clerk right now. That's all.
My time grows short. Quick!
Oh no! It's Belle! No, spirit, no, no, not this.
You remember?
I've tried not to.
Ebenezer?
Mm-hmm.
Ebenezer?
Yes, what is it?
I release you.
What?
It matters little to you. Very little. Another idol has replaced me. And if it can cheer and comfort you in time to come, as I would have tried to do, I have no just cause to grieve.
What idol has replaced you?
A golden one.
Well, this world is so convoluted. There is nothing on which this world is so hard as poverty. And yet the world ridicules those who pursue wealth with great severity.
Ebenezer, you fear the world too much. I've seen your noble aspirations fall off one by one until your greatest passion, the passion for gain, engrosses you. Have I not?
What then? Even if I have grown so much wiser, what then? I'm not changed towards you. Am I, Belle?
Our contract is an old one. It was made when we were both poor and content to be so, until, in good season, we can improve our worldly fortune by patient industry. You are changed, Ebenezer. When it was made, you were another man.
I was a boy.
Your own feeling tells you that you are not what you were. I am. That which promised happiness when we are one in heart is fraught with misery now. How often and how keenly I thought of it, I will not say. It is enough that I thought of it and can release you.
Have I ever sought release?
In words? No. Never.
In what then?
In a changed nature, in an altered spirit, in another atmosphere of life that made my love of any value or worth in your sight. Tell me, if this had never been between us, would you try to seek me out and win me now? Ah. No.
You think not.
I would gladly think otherwise if I could. But if you were free today, can even I believe that you would choose a dowerless girl? You, who now weigh everything by gain. Your present guiding principle blocks it. And I release you with a full heart for the love of him you once were.
Ma'am, listen.
You may, and the memory of what has passed, half makes me hope you will have pain in this for a very, very brief time, and that you will dismiss the recollection of it gladly as an unprofitable dream from which it happened well that you awoke. May you be happy in the life you have chosen.
Belle!
Belle!
You fool! You imbecile! Spirit, show me no more. Conduct me home. Why do you delight to torture me?
One shadow more.
No more. I do not wish to see it.
Then he, you never married, but she did.
Stop!
All right, that's one for each of you to put under the tree.
Thank you, Father.
Ah, but what's this? There seems to be something in my pocket.
Can you remember these being there?
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
You're welcome, my lovelies. Now, are the presents under the tree?
Yes, Father.
Then off to bed with you then.
We'll be up to tuck you in shortly.
Merry Christmas.
Oh.
What? Not until tomorrow. Belle, I saw an old friend of yours this afternoon.
Who was it?
Yes.
How can I? Don't I know? Mr. Scrooge?
Mr. Scrooge it was. I passed by his office window and it was not shut up, and he had a candle inside. I could scarcely help seeing him.
His partner lies on the point of death, I hear. And there he sat, all alone. Quite alone in the world, I do believe.
He's found his love. I was almost his, you know.
I am ever so grateful that you're mine.
I am the more grateful. Merry Christmas, dear.
Merry Christmas.
Stop. Stop, spirit, no more. No more. I beg you, I can bear it no longer.
I told you, these were the shadows of the things that have been. That they are what they are. Do not blame me.
Spirit, haunt me no longer. Take me home.
What spirit are you, if it please you?
I
and the ghost of Christmas present. Look upon me. You have never seen the likes of me before.
Never. And I've seen a number of great surprises recently.
And from surprises we can glean a great deal, Scrooge. You have never walked forth with the members of my family, meaning my elder brothers, have you?
Well, I don't believe so. I'm afraid I have not. Have you had many brothers, Spirit?
What year is it?
It's 1850.
I've had 1,850 brothers, then.
A tremendous family to provide for.
Funny man.
Spirit, you are the third specter that I have yet seen, but you are set apart by a display of bounty and riches.
Bounty, you call it? Riches?
Well, you seem to be quite wealthy.
Is that what attracts you to me, Scrooge? Wealth?
Well, I...
You have wealth, Scrooge. You've created a great treasure for yourself.
Why, thank you, Spirit. I've worked very hard.
I am not complimenting you. What you see around me is not bounty or riches, but that which is freely given. It is generosity, it is cheer, it is life lived to its fullest in honor of its creator and in honor of others. Do you understand?
Well, I...
Scrooge, you are winter itself, but every winter needs its spring.
Winter? Spring? What are you talking about? I just...
You are beginning to understand now. You want to laugh, don't you?
Laugh? Preposterous. Very idea is ridiculous. This is rather good, Spirit. Why, I remember a time on... This is excellent, Spirit. This is not wine. What is this?
It's what you've been missing, Scrooge. You've walked the earth blind. Are you ready to see the thing that you've been missing?
Spirit, conduct me where you will. I went forth last night under compulsion, and I learned a lesson that is working now. If you have aught to show me, pray, let me profit by it.
Touch my robe. You've been here before, Scrooge.
The city.
Yes, but this time look about you.
Merry Christmas, sir. Merry Christmas, ma'am. Do you have anything to spare today?
Of course.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh, dear.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, God bless you. Oh,
Merry Christmas. Christmas.
To the baker's. I thought you were going to pick it up. Don't blame me if the goose is... Well, it's a lovely night for a walk, isn't it?
A Merry Christmas Eve.
It is indeed, my love. A Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Spirit, is there any particular flavor that you sprinkle from your goblet?
Oh, there is. My own.
Would it apply to any dinner given on this day?
What's any kindly given to a poor one most?
Why to a poor one most?
Because a poor one needs it most.
Spirit, what place is this?
Don't you know?
Should I?
Mother, I can smell the goose from outside.
Well, I suppose at first it's mine.
Now it's mine!
Garlic.
And onions.
last night and had to clear away this morning, Mother.
Well, never mind so long as you are. Come, warm yourself by the fire. Lord bless ye.
No, no, there's Father coming!
Hide! Mother, hide!
Yes, Mother, hide!
Merry Christmas, my lovelies!
Merry Christmas, Father!
Merry Christmas!
Why, that's Bob Cratchit. It's my clerk. This is his home.
Why, where's our Martha?
Not coming.
Not coming? Not coming on Christmas Day. Well, then I guess she's under the table. There you are, my
dear. She's under the table.
All right, you've had your fun. Go on, get washed up for Christmas dinner.
Martha!
And how does little Tim behave?
Oh, as good as gold and better. Somehow he gets thoughtful, sitting by himself so much, and thinks the strangest things you ever heard. He told me, coming home, that he hopes the people saw him in the church, because he was a cripple, and it might be pleasant to them to be reminded upon Christmas Day that the Lord Jesus made lame beggars walk and blind men see.
Poor boy. Well, no matter, Christmas dinner is ready.
Everybody sit!
Can't hear the goose! She's been waiting all day! It's going to be absolutely
oh, wonderful goose, Mother! Merry Christmas to us all, my dears. God bless us.
God bless us.
God bless us, everyone.
Spirit, tell me that Tiny Tim will live.
I see a vacant seat in the poor chimney corner, and a crutch without an owner carefully preserved. If these shadows remain unaltered by the future, the child will die.
No, 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 kind spirit, say that he will be spared.
If these shadows remain unaltered by the future, none other of my race will find him here. What then? If he be like to die, he had better do it and decrease the surplus population. Ah, man, if man you be in heart, forbear that wicked kind until you have discovered what the surplus is and where it is. Will you decide what men shall live, what men shall die? It may be that in the sight of heaven, you are less fit to live than millions like this poor man's child.
Mr. Scrooge, I'll give you Mr. Scrooge, the founder of the feast.
The founder of the feast, indeed. I wish I had him here. I'd give him a piece of my mind to feast upon, and I hope he'd have a good appetite for it.
My dear, the children, Christmas Day.
Oh, it should be Christmas Day. I'm sure on which someone drinks the health of such an odious, stingy, hard, unfeeling man as Mr. Scrooge. You know he is, Robert. Nobody knows it better than you do. Poor fellow.
My dear, Christmas Day.
I'll drink his health for your sake and for the day's, not for his. To Mr. Scrooge, long life to him. A Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. He will be very merry and very happy, I have no doubt.
Come now, where's our merriment?
Joy to the world, the Lord
Nothing to say against him.
Oh, I am sure he is very rich, Fred. At least you always tell me so.
Yes, but his wealth is of no use to him. He doesn't do any good with it. He doesn't make himself comfortable with it. He hasn't the satisfaction of thinking... He hasn't the satisfaction of thinking that he's ever going to benefit us with it.
I have no patience with him.
I have. I am sorry for him. I couldn't be angry with him if I tried. Well, who suffers by his ill whims? Himself, always. Here, he takes it into his head to dislike us, and he won't come and dine with us. So what's the consequence, What is it? Well, he doesn't lose much of a dinner.
Indeed, I think he loses a very good dinner.
Well, I'm very glad to hear it, because I haven't great faith in these young housekeepers, but thank you.
Oh, do go on, Fred. He never finishes what he has to say. He's such a ridiculous fellow.
I was only going to say that the consequence of his taking our dislike to us and not making merry with us is, as I think, that he loses some pleasant moments which could do him no harm. Well, I mean to give him the same chance every year, whether he likes it or not. For I pity him. Oh, he may rail at Christmas till he dies, but he can't help thinking better of it. I defy him. If he finds me going there, yes, in good temper, year after year, and saying, Uncle Scrooge, well, how are you? If it only puts him in the vein to leave his poor clerk, say, £50, well, that's something. And I think I shook him the other day. All right. Enough of these. Let's start with the games. What shall it be first?
Forfeit.
Oh, I love this. Ah,
Christmas is the time to be children, for sure. Yes.
I have the first game, Fred.
Ooh, what's that, my sweet?
We'll play yes and no.
Then you have to think of something, and the rest must find out what by you answering only yes or no.
Yes and no it is, then.
Have you thought of something?
Ooh, most great. Yes, I have something.
Are you ready?
Yes.
All right, I'll start. Is it an animal?
Yes.
Is it a live animal?
Yes. Oh. Yes. Yes. Is it a rather disagreeable animal? Yes, 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 yes.
Is it an animal that growls and grunts sometimes?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Is it a savage animal?
Oh, certainly savage.
Oh. Is it an animal that's bred for show?
Oh, no, heavens, oh. No, no.
Is it led by someone?
No, no, definitely not.
Is it something that is killed in the market?
Oh, no.
Is it a horse?
No. Is it an ass? Oh! Yes!
Is it a cow?
No.
Is it a bull?
No.
A tiger? Oh, no.
A dog?
No.
A pig?
No, no, no.
A cow?
No, no. A bear!
No. Oh! Does it live in London?
Yes, yes, it does!
Does it walk about the streets?
Yes, yes, it does! Yes, it does.
Is it an animal that talks sometimes?
Yes!
Yes.
Such fun spirit! such fun. One half hour more, Spirit, only one more half hour.
But I'll offer to go if anybody else will. how did I think of it? I'm not at all sure that I wasn't his most particular friends. We actually used to speak from time to time. Good night, Will. Merry Christmas. Good night, chaps.
Merry Christmas.
I know these people's spirit. Why these trivial conversations? What does it all mean? Is it some sort of riddle, spirit?
Down rings and all with him lying there.
Of course I do. Why shouldn't I?
You're born to make your fortune and you'll certainly do it.
I certainly shan't hold my hand when I can get anything in it by reaching it out. For the sake of such a man as he was, I promise you, Joe.
His blankets?
Who else is, do you think? He isn't likely to take cold without him, I dare say.
Well, I hope he didn't die of anything catching, eh?
Don't you be afraid of that. I'm so fond of his company as to lie about in such things if he did. Ma, you may look through that shirt till your eyes ache, but you shan't find a hole in it, nor a thread their place. It's the best he had. Fine one, too. They'd have wasted it if it hadn't been for me.
What do you call wasting of it?
Putting it on him to be buried in, to be sure. Somebody was fool enough to do it, but I took it off again. It's what is becoming to the body. He can't look uglier than he did in that one, to be sure.
It was quite fine. All right, here's your account. Spirit, this is a fearful place, but in leaving it, I shall not leave its lesson, trust me, but let us go. understand you, and I would do it if I had the strength, but I have not the power, Spirit. I have not the power. If there is someone, anyone in this whole town who feels some emotion connected with this man's death, show that person to me, Spirit. I beseech you. Show me some tenderness connected with the death, but the memory of this dark chamber shall haunt me forever.
And he called them unto him and said to them, Suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these.
The color hurts my eyes.
The color?
They're better now again. It makes you weep by candlelight. I wouldn't show you guys to your father when it comes for the world.
It must be near his time.
Past it, rather. But I think it's walked a little slower than he used to this last few evenings, Mother.
I have known him walk with Tiny Tim upon his shoulder very fast indeed.
And so have I. Often.
Yes, often.
Poor Tiny Tim.
But he was very light to carry, and your father loved him so that it was no trouble. No trouble. Look, there's your father at the door.
Such pretty needlework, my love, is.
Sunday. You went today, then, Robert?
Yes, my dear. I wish you could have gone. Would have done you good to see how green a place it is. But you'll see it often. I promised him that I would walk there on a Sunday.
My little child. My little child. One of these days. Now, there's plenty of time for it, it seems, my dears. But however and whenever we part from one another, we shall none of us forget poor Tiny Tim, shall we? Or this first parting that there was among us?
No, Father.
And I know, my dears, that when we recollect how patient and how mild he was, although he was a little child, we shall not quarrel easily among ourselves and forget poor Tiny Tim in doing it.
Never, Father.
I am very happy. I am very happy. Tiny Tim! Oh, Bob! Spirit! Something informs me that our parting is at hand. I know it, but I know not how. Tell me! Tell me who that man was that we saw lying dead. Before I draw nearer to that stone to which you point, answer me one question. Are these the shadows of the things that will be?
Are these the shadows of the things that may be only... men's courses will foreshadow certain ends, which, if the courses be persevered in, they must lead, but if the courses be departed from, the ends must change. Say it is thus with what you show me. Ebenezer Scrooge? Am I that man who lay upon the bed? Oh, no, spirit, no, not then. Not then, spirit.
Savior, who daily bears our burden. Oh, I must be dressed.
I don't care. I would rather be a baby. Oh, Ebenezer Scrooge, look out on the feast of Stephen. Hello there. Yes, you boy. Yes, up here. Yes, hello. Hello there.
Hello.
What's today, my fine fellow?
Eh?
What's today? It's Christmas Day. I haven't missed it. The spirits have done it all in one night. What am I talking about? They can do anything they like. Of course they can. Yes. Hello, my darling.
Hello.
Do you know the butcher's shop in the very next street but one at the corner?
I should have, I did.
Ah, an intelligent boy. A remarkable boy. Now, do you know if they've served the prize turkey that was hanging there? No, not the little prize turkey. The big one.
What? As big as me?
What a delightful boy. It's a pleasure talking to him. Yes, my darling.
It's hanging out.
Is it? Well, go and buy it.
Get one.
No. I am in earnest. You go and buy it and tell the man to bring it back here. Now, and I shall give him the direction that he is to take it. Now, you come back with the man and you shall have a shilling. But come back with him in 5 minutes and you shall have half a crown. I'll send it for Bob Cratchit, though he shan't know who sent it. Oh, it's twice the size of Tiny Tim. Yes, I should need that Christmas scarf. My best coat. Oh, I can't believe it. It's Christmas Day. I haven't missed it. My best hat. Oh, where am I? The wreath. It's still here. Oh, it's still here. Oh, come on, ye faithful. Joyful and triumphant, yes, wonderful, wonderful, perfect. Oh, and here's the turkey. A Merry Christmas to you, sir, and a Merry Christmas to you, my boy. Thank you for being so prompt. Now, let me see. Oh, now, that is a turkey. That is a turkey. That bird couldn't have stood upon his legs. He'd have snapped them clean off. Now, as for you, my boy, 5 crowns, wasn't it? Here we are. Merry, merry Christmas to you, my boy. Thank you for being so very quick indeed. Now, as for you, sir, you are to take this bird to 1310 West Pickwick Street in Camden Town and be quick about it. Why, that bird is far too heavy for you to carry all that way, sir. You must have a cab. Yes, yes, here you are, and keep the rest.
Oh, why, thank you, sir.
Merry Christmas.
And to you, too.
Merry Christmas. Yes, a Merry Christmas to you both. Ah, what a delightful pair.
I can't believe it's Christmas already. Okay.
Aha! Salute my head! Merry Christmas, children! Merry, merry Christmas to you. A merry Christmas to you.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, Mr. Scrooge. Oh,
of all the blithe sounds I have ever heard, sir, those four the blithest matters. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Merry Christmas. A blessed Christmas to you. A happy, happy Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. For Jesus Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day.
To save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Yes, yes, wonderful, wonderful. Merry Christmas to you, my boy. Something for you here. Yes. Wonderful carol, and something for you too, my dear. A happy Christmas to the both of you. Blessings of the season to you. A Merry Christmas to you, my dear.
Merry Christmas,
and a happy Christmas to you, sir.
Merry Christmas, Mrs. Scrooge.
Compliments of the season to you both. Oh, my dears, my dears, my dears, what good work you are doing for the poor.
Thank you. Sir?
It's really very, very kind of you both. I hope you were successful in your efforts yesterday. Bless you for doing it. Bless you.
Mr. Scrooge?
Yes. That is my name, though I fear it may not be pleasant to you. Allow me to ask your pardon, and if you will have the goodness.
Lord bless me, my dear Mr. Scrooge. Are you serious?
If you please, and not one farthing less. A great many back payments are included in it, I assure you.
Will you do me that favor?
My dear sir, we don't know what.
No, don't say anything. Don't say anything, please. Come and see me. Will you come and see me?
We will.
Thank you. Merry Christmas to you both.
Merry Christmas.
Everybody a song before dinner, then we'll all go in for the meal.
Yes, everybody is.
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a Happy New Year. Oh, bring us a piggy pudding and a cup of good cheer.
My love.
He's in the parlour, sir, with mistress, getting me for dinner. Shall I let him know?
If you don't mind, I shall show myself in. But it's all right, child, he knows me. Merry Christmas.
We won't go until we get some. We won't go until we get some.
I won't go until I get some.
So bring some out here. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. And a Happy New Year!
Fred?
I bless my soul, who's that?
It is I, your Uncle Scrooge. I've come to dinner. Will you let me in, Fred?
Uncle, I'm all amazement. After all these years, here you are.
Here I am.
For Christmas dinner.
If you'll have me.
You've come.
Ta-da!
You're very welcome, Uncle. Very welcome indeed. Come, everyone, Uncle Scrooge.
Three cheers for Mr. Scrooge. Hip, hip.
Hurrah!
Hip, hip.
Hurrah!
Hip, hip.
Bob's late. Joy to the world, for Bob is late. Oh, this is working out better than I could have hoped for.
Grave news indeed, sir. I'll collect my things. I'm sorry to have disappointed you.
I am disappointed, Cratchit. With myself. And that's why I have resolved to raise your salary.
Ha ha ha!
many a year. I shall raise your salary. I shall endeavor to help your struggling family. And we shall discuss your affairs this very afternoon over a hearty Christmas bowl of smoking Bishop Bob. Now go. Make up the fires. You buy another coal scuttle before you dot another I, Bob Cratchit.
Nature.